We'll start in couple of minutes.
मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। Okay, so in our earlier class we have discussed about the natural vegetative propagation. Natural vegetative propagation. Okay, that means without the help of seeds, okay, without the help of flowers, the plants are able to increase their generation, the next generation they are able to produce. So vegetative method, okay, that is whatever the normal plant body is there, from that plant body only new plant you can make it. So natural vegetative propagation, so by nature, by itself, these things are taking place. So we saw that there is the natural vegetative propagation by roots and by stem. In the case of potato, natural vegetative propagation take place by what method?
Tuber.
Tuber. In ginger, natural vegetative propagation takes place by what method?
Rhizome.
By rhizome. Okay. So rhizome, tuber in onion, garlic, so on, is by bulb. All of these are modified stems we saw yesterday, and colocasia and gladiolus, that is the corm and runner in strawberry. So these things we saw yesterday. Today we will be looking at the natural vegetative propagation by the leaves. So there are some plants, like in your textbook page number 18, you can see bryophyllum. There is a plant called bryophyllum. So this bryophyllum, if a leaf is detached from the plant, is broken away from the plant and it falls on the soil, okay, or any suitable place, it will start making roots. So some plants produce adventitious buds at the margin of the leaves. These buds grow into small plantlets either when the leaves fall on the ground or when they are still attached to the plant. So when you look at this leaf, figure 2.8, okay, name of the plant is Bryo, B-R-Y-O, Bryophyllum, P-H-Y-L-L-U-M, Bryophyllum. Okay, so this Bryophyllum leaf sometimes even it is still attached to the plant also, from the leaf itself roots will start forming. Okay, they have some buds which are known as adventitious buds. Okay, these buds, they are present in the margin of the leaves. So if the leaf is like this, okay, so it is having some kind of it's not plain, like, you know, the leaf is not like this with the smooth edges. It is like this, having this zigzag edges. Okay, so at this point of this zigzag where it is there, from there there will be a bud, and from that bud the roots can form. Okay. Each of this one is able to produce a roots. So if you cut this small portion of that leaf, you plant it in the soil, you can grow this plant. So in this way, from the leaves also natural vegetative propagation can take place. So on separation from the leaf, the plantlets develop roots and they give rise to the independent plant. The example is bryophyllum and begonia. Okay, from the adventitious buds. Okay, so we saw three types. One is the roots, vegetative propagation by roots, by the stem. Under stem there are different modification, and by the modification of the leaves. So three types of the natural vegetative propagation. We will see some questions are there, learning milestone, fill in the blanks. I will ask specific students, you can answer. Yagya, roll number 62.
Yes, sir.
Plants with different characteristics can be produced by dash.
Yes, sir.
Plants with different characteristics can be produced by dash.
By sexual
reproduction. Okay, so you can note it in your textbook. Plants with different characteristics can be produced by the sexual reproduction. So the main difference between vegetative and sexual reproduction is, in vegetative reproduction, directly some part of the plant will grow into the new plant. So it will be the exact copy of that parent. Exact copy. Okay. But in sexual reproduction, they will be the male and female, the two partners will be there. Each of them will have the different characters. So because they have the different characters, there will be a mixing of the genes, the mixing of the characters. So the new generation will have the different characters. Next question, Tanay, can you? Yeah. So, Tanay, question number 2, ginger and turmeric reproduce vegetatively by dash. Ginger and turmeric, they reproduce vegetatively by rhizome. By rhizome. Okay, rhizome. Okay. So, rhizome is ginger, turmeric, both of them say they look very same, just only in the turmeric you are having the yellow pigments. When you see like this, almost it looks similar only. Tuber is coming with a potato. Okay, next. In bryophyllum, Shreya, 53. In bryophyllum, vegetative reproduction takes place by adventitious bud present on dash.
Leaves.
On leaves. Yes, correct answer. Next, Sanjoli Priya, roll number 50. The large underground stem containing stored food and eyes with buds is formed in question number 4. Large underground stem containing stored food and eyes with buds is found in potato or colocasia?
Potato.
In potato. Correct.
Potato.
Yes. Next.
The last one I.
I think we will have many more questions. Huh? Saksham 48. The horizontal stem which runs parallel to the ground is called dash, runner or rhizome. Saksham 48. Okay, next. Priya 46. Can you answer? Question number 5.
Sir, I can say.
Okay, go ahead.
Runner.
Is it?
Runner. Sir, runner is the answer.
Okay, why you think the answer is runner?
So is it grows parallel to the ground?
Yes. So is it a stem?
No, sir, stem.
Stem is now if you consider this rhizome is a stem or not?
Sir, rhizome is a stem.
Is a stem. A runner?
Yes, sir.
Is also stem.
Sir, it is a branch.
It is,
yes, sir.
It stem. Is an aerial stem and it is like a horizontal branch. Okay. So, in these two, which one you consider will be the, now this ginger, whether it is growing vertically or it is growing horizontally? The rhizome. When you compare rhizome and corm, C-O-R-M, corm, okay, when you compare both of these, the corm is growing in what direction? Corm is growing in vertically.
Consent.
Vertically. Okay, vertically means upright. It is going upright. Corm is going upright. But ginger, they will grow like this. That is, rhizome will grow horizontally. So you see, runner also going horizontal, rhizome also going horizontal only. Now you have to decide between these two. Now you tell.
Sir, in the night, were parallel to the ground.
Both are going parallel to the ground.
Yes, sir.
Now you choose the best out of these two.
Sir, rhizome.
Rhizome. Because, why?
Sir, because a rhizome is a horizontal stem.
Yes, it is a horizontal stem. The main difference here, what is coming, a runner is aerial stem, rhizome is underground stem. Okay, rhizome is underground stem, whereas runner is a aerial stem. Both are going parallel. But when you say it runs parallel, that means what? It will go long distance.
Yes, sir.
Then your answer, your original answer becomes correct. That is the runner becomes
runner.
Okay. Because if this term is not there, okay, the reason why we discuss this one, so that you are able to clearly understand the difference between rhizome and runner. So rhizome is underground stem, runner is aerial stem.
Horizontal.
Aerial. It is in the air. Aerial stem. Okay. And both are going parallel. This is also going underground parallel. That is going above ground parallel. But ginger will not run like this runner. It will go long distance. Runner means you're going long distance. Okay. So more appropriate answer will be runner. Okay. Now, next.
Artificial vegetative propagation.
Yeah, till now we saw the natural vegetative propagation. Next is the artificial vegetative propagation. Artificial. Okay. We are saying it is artificial, it is not natural. That means, who is doing it? if the cows and buffaloes will do it, whether it will be called artificial or natural vegetative propagation?
Natural.
It's still natural only. Only if humans will do it, will become artificial. Okay. So here in plants, where vegetative propagation by natural methods is difficult to take place, human beings carry out some special methods for vegetative propagation. These methods are called artificial vegetative propagation. Okay, this is the fast method. Artificial vegetative propagation includes cutting, layering, grafting. So what happens is, in the nurseries, or people are doing gardening or they are doing farming, so sometimes we need to multiply that plant very quickly. We want more plants. And the plants have one beautiful property that they are what we say totipotent. It is not important, don't go into the term. That means they, from their tissue, you take any small tissue from them and you can grow the whole plant. But in animals, is it possible? So we cannot be like some magic, you know, take little part of the hand or nose or something and throw it like that and it will become the new clone. That is not possible. But for plants, it is possible. Plants have that ability. Any small tissue, you can take it and you can make the whole plant out of it. So till now we saw that whether it is the stem, it is the root or the leaf, okay, we can use this all natural, artificial, the natural vegetative propagation methods are already there. So what humans are doing is, they are using some special methods to propagate these plants. One is called the cutting. Simple term, cutting means simply cut it. So what we are going to cut? Stems with buds are cut into long pieces. Okay, so a bud here, generally what you will see in most of the plants near the leaf, okay, base of the leaf, there will be some bud will be there. Okay, you will see some small swollen structure. Okay, that is a bud will be there. So that should be there. So stems with buds, they are cut into the long pieces. They are cut obliquely and planted into the moist soil. After few days, the cuttings will develop roots and shoots and they will grow into new plant. Stem cuttings are commonly done in plants like rose. Okay, so basically if there is a plant and it is having some things like this, some are there. Okay, so you can make a small cutting of this one. For example, here once some stem is there, you can make a cutting of this one and this one can be planted into the soil. But how we are cutting it? We are cutting it slanting like this. Here down it is a slanting. So here there will be more surface area. More surface area will be there when you are cutting it slant. Yes. So generally rose is most common. Most of the people may have seen. Okay, they want to you in your home, I saw that rose plant is very nice, I also want it. People ask, then what you will do? Okay, from one branch I will cut like this, the oblique little bit slanting, and you can gift it so that other person can take it and just put it into the soil. Okay, so after a few days roots will start coming from here and it will grow into the new plant. So the rose, China rose. Okay, in Google you can search what are these plants. Sugarcane, most of you know. Lemon, you know. Okay, so these plants are very commonly, hibiscus. Okay, all of these kind of plants very easily by cutting they can be propagated. So this is a method of the artificial vegetative propagation. The next one is a layering. L-A-Y-E-R-I-N-G, layering. That means what? Some layer is going on. What layer is going on? In this method, a portion of the lower branch of the plant, lower branch of the plant with bud at the node is bent down to the ground and covered with soil. So you can see the figure 2.10, page number 20. In page number 20, figure 2.10, if you see. So the plant is there, it's not a very strong or large plant, so these are generally like herbs and shrubs kind of things, small plants, like a strawberry, so you saw that strawberry is a runner, no? So one branch will go like this, almost horizontal to the soil, and wherever it is touching the soil, there it can make roots again. It can make roots again, and from here again the new plant will come. So purposefully what you can do is, for example, strawberry is there, purposefully you can bend some of the stem into the ground and put some soil on that one, and there the rooting will start and it can start making the new plant. So basically what you are doing, you are making a little bit layer of soil over the branch. That is what layering, you are putting a layer of soil. The apical portion of the branch is left exposed to the air that later develops the leaves. After some time, roots develop from the parts that is under the soil. These branches can be cut from the parent plant and grow into the new plants. Example, jasmine, strawberry and raspberry. They can be propagated by layering. So immediately when the term layering will come, you should think about what layer, putting a layer of soil, on what, on this branch, and it can grow into the new plant. After that, if you cut this place, no problem, it can still grow. That is a layering. Next method is the grafting. Grafting is more important method. Questions, more questions every year will come with grafting. It's also very important, and in the nurseries this method is used commonly. Most of the gardeners will use the method that is grafting. So what is this grafting? The stem cuttings from two different plants are taken. In cutting and layering, only one plant is involved. But in grafting, they will be the two plants. The stem cutting with root is called the stalk. That means, this is one plant A. What we have done, we cut it. With the root, what this plant is there, we say that it is the stalk. The stalk is always from a plant which is resistant to disease. That means if any ants are there, or some kind of like that bugs are there, they cannot, because resistant bacteria cannot, so the stalk should be disease resistant, and it has a deep root for absorbing water and minerals. Roots should be deep. The scion is from a plant with large size and nutritious fruits. The stalk and scion are obliquely cut. So stalk and scion, S-C-I-O-N, scion. Stalk, scion. So stalk is the lower part of the plant which is having the roots, it should be disease resistant. Scion is the upper part, the plant which you want, for example, mango. Okay, mango grafting is being done. So, they will put one, one plant will be there, which is already there in the soil. Okay, and we know this variety should have good roots and all these kind of properties. And this one you will choose, stock. This is Scion, you will choose one with very nice fruit. Okay, so many varieties of mangoes are there in Bhagalpur region. Okay, so something that is a mal.